Ladies and gentlemen and hockey fans of Asia, it is December. It's getting close to Christmas. The malls are full with Santa. You know hockey's in full season. But the best thing of all, the World Juniors is just around the corner for those young, great, talented players we get to see in December. And possibly who's going to get a close look at who's going to be taken first overall in the draft. My name is Randy Dillon. Welcome back to another exciting edition of Randy Talks Hockey. It's been another whirlwind week in the NHL. We got lots to talk about and we got you covered for what has happened. The big news of the week, John Hines has been fired by the New Jersey Devils. This has, I don't think, a surprise to anyone. The start of the Devils have just been horrible. All the moves Ray Sherrard did, acquiring P.K. Subban, Nikita Gusev, drafting Jack Hughes. The Devils thought they were going to do better. I thought they were going to make the playoffs. Oh, I was completely wrong. Probably a bunch of other people are wrong. Now, the big thing for the Devils is they do have other questions to do, because I think the decision is they are going to rebuild. It's going to have to wait another year, hopefully for next year to be better. But they got assets to work with. Players like Sammy Vatanen and Wayne Simmonds, for example, are UFA's at the end of the year. You can probably get some assets. But what about Taylor Hall? I think his time in Jersey, we know, is done, unless he gets a heck load of money. But where is he going to go? And the big thing is, from what I've heard over the radio, is Taylor Hall maybe wants to be a free agent. If that's the case, how does it affect some teams trying to acquire him, like contending teams trying to acquire him? Do you give up those assets knowing he's going to leave at the end of the year? Or are you going to say, hey, Taylor, tell New Jersey and Ray Sherrill, hey, we'll give you the assets, but Taylor Hall got to sign that 8-year extension. We'll see what happens. Where will Taylor Hall be traded? Honestly, it'd be funny if he goes back to the Edmonton Oilers, but I don't think the Oilers have the cap base to bring Taylor Hall back. The all likelihood is the Colorado Avalanche. They got cap base. They got assets. Hey, Montreal Canadiens, they need a good top forward, but they're... But are you willing to take that risk if Taylor Hall leaves at the end of the year? Maybe the New York Islanders. They look like a good contending team. They have assets to work with. Only time will tell on what will happen with the future of Taylor Hall, ladies and gentlemen. But the big question is, which coach is next to go? I think the two coaches that are on the major hot seat are Peter Laviolette from the Nashville Predators and Pete DeBoer from the San Jose Sharks. I originally did not have Pete DeBoer on the hot seat because they changed the Sharks goal, but it's a big year for the Sharks. Let's not forget, they don't have a first-round pick, so if they do bad, they're not going to really get assets in return. Nashville, this is their last chance to win. We've emphasized this a lot, and the Preds, they were on a bit of slide. They got back a win, back in the win. They're still quite a little bit out of the playoff wild card spot. We'll see how the weeks continue up, especially to the All-Star break when we hit the halfway mark of the season. Now, the culture of coaches is under a microscope, ladies and gentlemen. It is not looking good. Mark Crawford has left the Chicago Blackhawks with an investigation, with Sean Avery saying he choked me, abusive to me. We are hearing stories from a good hard player like Johan Frenzen, the Mule, saying there was an issue with Mike Babcock and him. Chris Chelios has got involved in saying a few things about Babcock. And then we heard from the Edmonton Oilers GM, former Red Wing GM Ken Holland, saying, yeah, he was aware of an issue before, but not a later issue. Lots going to happen, but I'm interested not hearing one coach's name. John Tortorella. You would think Torts is fiery. He has a little bit of a tasty mouth where he let the words go, but we haven't heard anything bad about him. Maybe Torts is the kind of coach that said, hey, I'm tough on my players, but I know what the fine line is, or maybe players are it's just a matter of time. Who knows? We'll have to see what will happen. There was a trade that happened earlier this week. Chandler Stephenson of the Washington Capitals is now a member of the Vegas Golden Knights. The Caps got a fifth-round pick exchange for Stephenson. I think Stephenson is way worth more than a fifth. I'm a big fan of Chandler Stephenson. He was instrumental in the Caps Cup win in 2018. He can play up and down the lineup. He can play center. He can play wing. He's good on faceoff. He was 50%. Over the last few years with the Capitals. Now, it hasn't gone good really with him and new head coach Todd Reirden like it did with former head coach Barry Trotz. But sometimes it just doesn't happen. I wish Chandler all the best in Vegas. He did score in his first game in Vegas. Way to go, Chandler. And this will help the Golden Knights. They did lose a lot of depth with Carpenter and Belmar leaving, so Stevenson will help replenish some of that debt. I do want to talk about one player here, though, that it might be a good thing to talk about. Marcus Hoberg of the Ottawa Senators. He's played 3 games so far this year, and in those 3 games, he looked pretty good. He was good against the Calgary Flames. He did allow that late goal after they tied it. Vancouver didn't have much work. He came in with 4-0, and yesterday in Edmonton, he did a great job. This is good news for the Sens because they got Hoberg and part of the Derek Brassard trade. Craig Anderson contract is expired at the end of this year, so maybe a goalie of the future to work with, and that really would be a good thing for the Sens because you know goaltending is an important part in this league to win. The Penguins, again, are suffering through so many injuries. They've lost Ryan Dumoulin and Patrick Hornquist, but they do find a way to win. They did beat St. Louis the other day 3-0. Tristan Jarry did get the shutout, but for the Pens, man, you just gotta wrap a bandage around them or put like that heavy super glue on them so they don't keep breaking down. They're just suffering through injuries, but they are finding a way to keep competitive in the playoff hunt. You gotta give credit to Mike Sullivan. Like I said, I think he could be a candidate for coach of the year if the Pens are able to make the playoffs. The Canadiens' winless days are done. They did get a win against the New York Islanders in the snap an 8-game losing streak. But what I like the most from that game, Carey Price aggressiveness. He gave them Islanders played a couple of whacks, took a penalty. But I think it's just the anger from the Canadiens. A lot of pressure now on the step that he on Mark Bergevin. He has to do something to make this team better in the short term because they were so close last year making the playoffs. This year they're sliding out of missing. They're sliding right now, possibly missing the playoffs. We'll see what Mr. Bergevin can do. Now, early in the video, we did talk about World Juniors. They're going to get December 26th, the tournament starts. It's a great time to start looking at some young, great players. You possibly got the top player that could possibly draft in Alex Lafontaine going to be playing for Canada. Then you got other players like Cole Brawfield. You got Yaroslav Achifor and Lucas Raymond. Some great young players just to call a few. It's a great way for some of those young, disappointing teams, or even look at to say who we're going to draft, who do we think going to fit our team, like the Ottawa Senators, the Detroit Red Wings, possibly the Columbus Blue Jackets, possibly, well, the Los Angeles Kings, obviously. Good way to start looking to see what talent is available at the draft. And then for other teams, you can look at your other assets that got to play, you drafted last year. Players like, now we're not going to see Jack, who is Kako Kappe, but players like Bowen Byron, who was fourth overall. Then you got defenseman Philip Broberg, who's going to be in Sweden. Vladimir Podaskin playing in Russia. You got Cole Caulfield, Dylan Dugat, Dylan Cousin, Travis Zegras, Dennis Jordanson, Matthew Boldy, just to name a few. I could go on, but we would be here all day. But you and Spencer Knight, you're going to get a good look for some of those teams and what our assets are made of. The Avalanche are getting healthy. They're climbing the status. Mikko Rantanen is back, and he had 5 points in 2 games. Just incredible. The Avalanche are going to pick up back where they left off before all those injuries, and they were able to keep in the run with those injuries. That's what you call impressive, ladies and gentlemen. Now, the final thing I just want to say, congratulations to former NHL player Alex Burrows. He played with the Vancouver Canucks, Ottawa Senators. Burrows was a big part of the Canucks' success from mid-2009 to the end of 2013. Many good high-scoring goals. He had the biggest goal in Canuck history, which was the overtime winner against the Hawks, that commonly known as Slaying the Dragon. I remember watching that game, and boy, oh boy, I was so happy when that goal was scored. I was in high school as well, so you imagine, the Canucks lose that game, oh boy, I did not want to go to school that day. Anyways, that's all I got for you today, ladies and gentlemen. We will be back with another edition upcoming. We will cover more World Juniors, see what else is happening around the NHL, more breaking news, possible trades, which team's going to slide, which team's going to come up, all that wonderful fun stuff. My name is Randy Dillon, and always remember to watch some hockey.